Good morning, ma'am. Good morning, classmates. I am Christy Manriquez Chamande, your reporter for today. I am tasked to discuss to you Lev Vygotsky's scaffolding. But before that, let me introduce to you first who is Lev Vygotsky. Lev Vygotsky is a Russian psychologist in 1930s, died at the age of 38. Graduated from Moscow State University and worked at the Psychologist Institute in Russia. Lev Vygotsky believed that learning does not occur in isolation, but rather, learning is a social process guided by interactions with a skillful tutor. Now, the mentioned skillful tutor here could be the child's parent, an educator, or teachers like us, a more competent peer, or someone with knowledge and skills beyond that of the learner. They are most commonly known as the more knowledgeable other, or MKO, as what Lev Vygotsky termed it. Now, the kind of help or assistance that the MKO gives to the learner in order to step to the next level is what we call scaffolding. In other words, scaffolding is the role of the teachers and the more knowledgeable others in supporting the learner's development and providing support structures to get to the next level or stage. Now, there are three main features of scaffolding. First, we have contingency. Contingency is when the teacher evaluates the student's performance and provides appropriate support in specific tasks. Second is the fading. As the students become able to carry out tasks independently, the scaffolding gradually withdraws. Therefore, that is what we call fading. And lastly is the transfer of responsibility. It is when the responsibility of performing tasks is gradually transferred from teacher to students or from the more knowledgeable other to the child. Now, why scaffolding is important? When a teacher can scaffold strategy in teaching learning activities in classroom, it definitely helps students to become self-regulated, independent, and a problem solver, which ultimately helps in upgrading the quality, learning outcome, and cognitive development of students. Now, when we also incorporate scaffolding in classroom, we become more of a mentor and facilitator of knowledge rather than the domain content expert as a teacher. Now, I have here example in implementing scaffolding in a classroom setting. Say, for example, we are teaching formal letter writing. So the first thing that we need to do is to warm up our students. So warming up could be through asking them questions like, what was in your mind when you read a letter written for you? Did you keep the letter to read again? Did you share your letter with anyone? Did you write back? Now, after them answering those questions, we could already proceed to introducing the letter writing to our students. So, introducing could be through providing tools such as collecting different samples of the letters. So let the students sort them out into two groups, the sample letters that you have. It could be formal or informal letter. This allows a discussion to take place about the different types of letters. We could also ask them questions like, how was the address stated? Was it business or private? How about the greeting, formal or informal? The style of the letter, is it friendly or business? What is the message? How does the letter end? This will allow students to find out the parts of the letter and how to write it formal and informal way. Next is you have to model how to write a formal letter. Modeling means showing how to write a formal address, the greetings, the body, the concluding remarks, and so on and so forth. We could also use group work. Now, group work is a kind of collaborative learning, and Lev Vygotsky suggests that group members should have different levels of ability so more advanced peers can help less advanced members operate within their zone of proximal development. After that, we should guide our students through criticizing their work constructively, criticizing them in a way that you will check their work and suggest better ways to improve their output. And lastly, guide them also until they could write their own formal letter independently. Now, the theory of Lev Vygotsky can be summarized in this I do, we do, you do framework adapted from Pearson and Gallagher 1983. Now, as you can see in the left side of this figure, we have here the teacher's responsibility. Now, the first thing that the teacher needs to do is to explicitly model how to do the task. Then, the shared demonstration must be done between you as a teacher and your students or with their peers. Then guide them, suggest ways to improve their work until they could do it on their own. Now, as you can see in this figure, the teacher's responsibility is gradually withdrawn as the student slowly able to make the task independently. So that is the theory behind scaffolding. So here are my references, and I guess that's all. Thank you so much, and good morning.